The quartet we're doing tonight is from Eugene Onyegin by Tchaikovsky, which is originally written in Russian, but we're doing it in English. My character is Tatiana, and Lenski and Onyegin have just arrived.
Now tell me which of them's Tatiana.
Lenski is in love with Olga, Tatiana's sister, and he's just brought Onyegin along, and Tatiana takes one look at him and decides that he's the man for her. They all sing their own private thoughts about the situation.
She has a pretty face, much like the moon.
I hope it's interesting to do this particular scene because very little happens, basically. It's an entirely internal thing. There's no great aria, nothing like that. It's just simple thought, and it's the power of that thought and how one conveys it that is important in this scene.
What are you talking about here? I think we might as well discuss this because there are four very different personalities involved. Sometimes we can hear what you're saying and sometimes not. And so from an audience's point of view, we need to know what you're saying at any particular time. And there are certain times in this when we just need to hear certain lines come out. You two have the better of that because there are solo lines that really do strongly come forward. For you, your parts, it's not quite so easy for you, but I think that's quite deliberate because theirs is more descriptive somehow and yours is contemplative and pensive. Mm-hmm. So what are you talking about? Tell us what you're talking about.
She sees Onyegin and believes that this is the man she's been waiting for, the man she's been reading about in all her romantic novels, and this is the man that she's gonna marry. He's
exactly.
The one who's set her soul on fire.
It's as though she had a book there and was reading, and when she looked up, there was the figure. He came straight out of the picture. I've just been reading about you. And that's what Tatiana's like.
Yeah.
All right, and Olga?
I'm just quite excited because I've got a feeling that something's going to happen.
Between these two?
Yeah, between these two, and I know there's going to be gossip, and I'm quite...
And you like gossip?
Yeah.
You're a bubbly. I think you're very different. Like,
animal.
And you're already engaged to him, of course, who is...
I'm Lenski. I'm a young poet.
Yes.
And I've come to introduce my friend Onyegin.
Is he a long-term friend?
I'm not sure, actually.
I think he probably is. Yeah. And you had a history.
Yeah.
And very much the landed city man coming to the country and to this rather down-at-the-heel family. That's the way he is for the greater part of the time. Mm. And it's extremely rude. Let's go on for that. If I'm having a chat with you, it's fine like this, all right? Mm-hmm. If I start having a chat with you like this, unless it's a cocktail party or something, it says something else. If I'm like that, it says something else again.
Yes.
And I think Lenski is always a bit too much here.
Mm. Yeah.
And but... You're constantly trying to get it, make space between the two of you. You're not entirely happy with this relationship that's going on, and indeed it will blow up later. I think you, John, you think the world of this girl, and it seems ages since I saw you. That was yesterday. I know, but it seems like a long time ago. Oh, God, yeah. You're becoming boring. James, what were you doing back there?
In a world of my own.
Oh, in a world of your own.
I really don't work.
And now you've meandered over here, and you're in her world.
Well, I felt obliged to come over as...
You're watching the corn blowing. It's sort of late scene from Oklahoma or something. Yeah.
Sorry, with a fringe on top. Yeah.
The one thing that, when you do get over to here and you're together, don't do rhubarb talking.
Right.
I'll tell you why. Because if you do, you then find it difficult to get into a strained conversation anyhow, because you've already had one.
Yeah.
You haven't had a conversation up to this point. It's simply, well, what brings you here, then?
Yeah.
If there's anything goes on before that,
sure.
It confuses it.
Yeah.
For us.
Okay.
So leave it blank.
Mm.
You're just looking at the Russian sky. Dead Russian peasants. And then we get into the conversation after that, when you turn and have, you know, Tchaikovsky says, now using.
Sometimes we do have the luxury of the music stopping and we have dialogue. But that's a rarity for us, and usually it's determined for us. It's frustrating at times, because occasionally there's something that you might think, well, I don't want to say this just at the moment. And you have to say it then, because that's the way Mozart wrote it, or Beethoven wrote it, or whomsoever it might be.